guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I'm back with a new review video after a very long time. I feel like I've not reviewed a product in forever. So today I'm reviewing the brand new launch by Maybelline, which is the new Sensational Matte Lipstick. I took a poll on Instagram and this lipstick is the one that won against the Lacme new Forever Matte Liquid, something like that. And both of these lipsticks are very much in the affordable category, so a lot of people want to see this. But again, it was a close match, so I think I'm going to do a review on the Lacme ones as well. If you want to see that, then leave your thoughts in the comments below. And if a lot of people want to see that video too, then I think I'll go ahead and buy those lipsticks as well. But for today, if you want to see what I think and my honest opinion on the Maybelline Sensational Matte Lipstick, then please keep on watching. Okay, so just before we begin, I want to say that any questions about this makeup look is going to be answered on my IGTV. I've shot a makeup tutorial for my IGTV. It's a simple glam, which I think would be perfect for Valentine's Day. If you want to check that out, then head to my Instagram and follow me there. It will be up before Valentine's Day this week itself. For now, let's dive right into these lipsticks. This is what the lipsticks look like. I just have two of these because I've gone out and purchased these. These were not sent to me. And this is definitely not a sponsored video. None of my videos are. This is an honest review and opinion about these lipsticks and what I genuinely feel about them. So starting first off with the packaging. For me, this is like a perfect liquid lipstick packaging. I love the clear plastic over here that can tell you the color that the lipstick is, and the black over here makes it look very sleek and slim. The name is right here, the Maybelline Sensational Matte, and below you have a sticker with the number, so this is number 11. Inside, the doe foot applicator is also very good quality. It is a very soft, smooth doe foot applicator that layers very perfectly and also takes you in the cupid's bow for application really well. So all in all, for packaging, I give it an A+. Next, let's dive into the pigmentation of this lipstick. This lipstick is heavily pigmented. I have the number 11 on my lips right now, and this is just one swipe of the lipstick. I just dipped into the lipstick once and went across both my lips, and it was heavily pigmented. Just one swipe gives you full opacity. You don't have to layer it up, because the more you layer it, you might just make it look patchy. But if you do layer it also, it does not look patchy. So I really like the heavy and rich pigment. It's full opacity, not sheer at all. Exactly how good quality liquid lipstick should be. The third point I want to talk about is the texture of the lipstick. Now for me personally, in a liquid lipstick, keeping the packaging, the pigmentation, everything aside, the texture really matters, because some people are very sensitive to a heavily drying liquid lipstick. And for me per se, this liquid lipstick is not heavily drying. I've used liquid lipsticks which are much more drying than this one. But if you have really dry lips, because in the winter I've also been having really dry lips, you might need to use a lip balm underneath this. If you do use a lip balm, then it will like glide on very well on your lips. And this is not that kind of a liquid lipstick that if you put lip balm and then put your lipstick on, it's not going to set completely matte and remain that glossy texture. It will dry completely matte despite the lip balm underneath it. And the lip balm will keep your lips moisturized so that it doesn't look very dry. Because as the day goes ahead, this lipstick can get a little too drying. And that is some, like for me, lipsticks, I'm not very bothered by drying lipsticks, but this one could be a little bothersome for me too, so I also use a lip balm. So that's about the drying factor of it. For me, somewhere on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the most dry, this would come somewhere in 7 or 8. Not too drying, but not moisturizing at all. Secondly, the texture is also very weightless, which is something I was blown away by. It's such a lightweight lipstick. It feels like you have nothing on your lips. If I wasn't looking at myself in the camera, and this is something I always say about weightless lipsticks, if I wasn't looking at myself in the mirror, I wouldn't feel that there was lipstick on my lips. And this is something which is a very big deal when it comes to liquid lipsticks, because with bullet lipsticks, you can feel that way, but that weightless feeling. But a liquid lipstick feeling this weightless, this comfortable, is like a real achievement. So I really like that factor about this lipstick. Next, diving into how long lasting this lipstick is. Now, personally for me, I wear this to college. I have been testing it out the entire week. This is not a first impression. And I love the longevity of this lipstick. It lasts for 8 to 9 hours. I eat breakfast, I eat lunch, I eat my snacks. and the lipstick is still there put. You might need to use a makeup remover at the end of every one of your days to really get the lipstick off your lips, but the longevity is amazing. It is completely transfer proof, does not transfer at all, which is once again amazing. And you might tend to see that the lipstick does sink into your fine lines. Like, I don't even have that many fine lines on my lips, but it does emphasize my fine lines if somebody looks up really close to my lips. But honestly, nobody's getting that much into my face, and it's not seen from a distance. It's not that bothersome. But if you have fine lines, it might emphasize your fine lines. And over the day, if it's fading away, it will fade away from the inside more and not really from the periphery. So might give you a butthole lip sort of an appearance, and the butthole lip isn't also very prominent. So we spoke about packaging, we spoke about texture, we spoke about pigmentation, and we spoke about the longevity. And now let's dive into the fifth point, which matters the most, that the price range. I love the price on this lipstick. This is a 350 rupees lipstick, which is amazing, stunning price for the quality that you're getting in this lipstick. Honestly, how much ounces is this? 7 ml. You're getting 7 ml, which is a decent amount. You'll be using it for a really long time. Since the time I've gotten this lipstick, I've not been able to keep my hands off it. Both the colors that I've purchased are really beautiful, and they have a very nice variety of colors that you can choose from for every single skin tone. I'm gonna insert swatches after the review, so you can check those out. I just have two as of now, but I think I'm gonna dive into the reds as well as the maroons and the wine shade, because I just got the nudes for the daily basis. I really did not expect this lipstick to be this good, because honestly, Maybelline lipsticks have not blown my mind away in the past. I don't even own that many, but this lipstick really has blown away my mind with the price of it, the quality of it, everything. From my side, it's a total hit, and I totally highly recommend. I'm not even just saying that buy one and test it out if you like it. I highly recommend this lipstick. Everything about the lipstick is a pro for me, except the drying factor, which also can be dealt with a lip balm. So honestly, there is nothing negative I can see about this lipstick, right from the packaging to the formula to the price range. Everything is A plus, and I think you should definitely try this lipstick out. I'm gonna swatch two colors that I have right now, and then I'll give you all my final thoughts and close out this video. Talking about the two lipsticks that I have right here, the two shades that I've got with me and that you all saw in the swatches just now. The first shade that I have and I've been loving and using almost every day is the shade number 11. That is Made Easy. It's a perfect brown reddish undertone nude, which is my favorite category of nude lipsticks. I've come down to the conclusion that reddish, brickish undertone nude lipsticks suit me so well. Both of these lipsticks look beautiful on bare skin without any makeup on, and that's how I like to wear lipsticks on a daily basis. And also with makeup, it's just the perfect nude to tie any soft eye look together so beautifully, like the way I've done today. This is the lipstick which is on my lips right now, so this is my hands down my favorite. And if you're like dusky skin or even deeper than me, you should definitely go ahead and purchase shade number 11. So the next shade I have is the shade number 8, which is shade Sensationally Me. And this lipstick per se is a more of a pinky, not even nude, it's just straight out of a pink lipstick, but not fuchsia pink. It's a nice light pink color, so it's somewhere close to Diana, the Nykaa Ultra Matte Diana. It's pretty close to that, but it's much more brighter than Diana. And personally, it looks really, really good without any makeup on, but I like that one a little more. And if you're fair, like really fair, this lipstick looks really beautiful on you. Fair or medium skin tone, this looks really good. It looks very good on my skin as well, but I'm not such a pink lipstick preference person, so I don't use it as much as I use shade number 11, but I love it just as much. So this completes today's video. These were my honest thoughts and honest opinion about the Maybelline Sensational Matte Lipsticks. I feel like this was a very short review because it was not really a first impression. It was a blown out review. I've been testing them out for 2 weeks, and these were my honest thoughts about them. Let me know in the comments what you feel about them. Did you like the lipsticks? Have you tried them out? And have you liked them? Did you like the swatches or the colors that I picked out? Let me know everything in the comments below, and also which other videos you want to see on my channel in this new year. I will be back next Sunday with a new video. Until then, please do subscribe to my channel. Click on the big red subscribe button, and we've already hit 15,000 subscribers, which is such a big deal. So thank you guys so much for that. Click on that big red subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it so that you're notified every Sunday when I upload a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram if you want to see the tutorial on this look, which will come up very soon in this week. And I will see you in my next video next Sunday. Bye guys, love you all.